Ido. Hello, nice to see you. Congratulations on this extraordinary success that you're having with your business. You've had this amazing breakthrough with AT&T where you're actually now carrying 52% of their core cloud traffic. That's unheard of for a startup to have that level of success and with the largest service provider in the world. How have you managed to do that?
I think it's all about to create a value to your customer. So as long that you are able to prove them, that you are helping them to either create a new revenue or reducing the cost per bit or changing the economy of their network, they are with you. Yeah. Then you need to move to the next steps that you need to prove them that it's working. And this is generally of a few years that we are well known.
Yeah, and they're obviously happy. They're out talking about you and singing your praises. What do you think has been the biggest surprise for them, perhaps, in terms of the performance of the products?
That it's working. Yeah. I mean, really. I mean, they actually were very surprised by moving from the lab into production and not going back to the labs.
Right.
It was. It's usually the case. It's that you go to the lab, you go to the network, and then go back. In our case, it just. There, so they were very, very happy, and I think it was a great effort from their side as well.
Yeah.
And but you know, we needed to show that it's really working, yeah. And it served their needs.
Right.
This is not about just technology exercise.
Right.
It's really deliver value.
Right.
So as they make progress, they saw the advantages. And as it is bigger,
yeah.
The big advantage you get from it.
Well, let's talk about advantages. I think your company has been quoted as saying that you win 65% of the bids that you go in for as service providers against the incumbents like Cisco and Juniper and Nokia. What are you winning those bids based on? Is it saving money? Is it making money? Is it reliability? What are the criteria that you think that you win on?
Everybody wants to move to the next generation in order to create those value. But it's not a question anymore if the software or hardware will win. I think the battle already done. Everyone
right.
Moving to the cloud, it's not important if it's a private, hybrid, or public cloud. And we are the bridge for
right.
them to be able to move to those cloud. I hope to increase even more our converge rate, this is what we call, okay,
right.
of winning. We're working very hard to do it, but I think, as Hillel mentioned, we're going to the customer lab, we prove the technology is working, we're getting their trust, the technology trust. And then we help them to move there and convert the network to be a software-based solution. And then they start to see the benefit. AT&T mentioned about huge saving.
Yeah.
I can tell you that we have many customers that already use and see it and building a business model that see the same value and even bigger.
Right.
So I think this is all about.
And bear in mind one more thing, that they're really happy about the fact that we are very focused on the service provider.
Right.
If you think about the other incumbents,
yeah.
they have many businesses.
Yeah.
They have enterprises, they have many
yeah.
things. And we are very focused on them. So this is something that really they care much.
Well, they need to become operators of cloud networks. And you support, I think, mainly native cloud, right? It's not a halfway house of sort of an encapsulation or Kubernetes. Or this is real native cloud. And that seems to be, and we're at MWC, and that seems to be a theme here that we've kind of gone through the workarounds or the bootstrap versions of cloud, and now it's time for some cloud clarity, some pure native cloud implementations. Is that, that's really where you reside, is that right?
Yes, if I will compare what we are doing to what happened in the compute and the storage industry. So compute and storage industry start from the mainframe, move
yep.
to the x86, then VMware, or KVM, the virtualization come on top, and today everybody using the cloud, public
right.
cloud, private cloud, etc. I think we are doing the same. Okay, we took the white boxes as a layer of the x86 generic purpose. We developed the VMware of the world, our network cloud solution. Mm-hmm. And in the end of the day, I believe everybody will consume it as a cloud,
right,
either private or public or multi-cloud environment. I think we see exactly the same journey, but you know, you need to build the building for first floor, moving to the second, etc., until you're coming to the penthouse. And this is what we are doing.
Yeah. Can you give me a sense of what happens next for the company in terms of the company? I mean, you keep on getting these extraordinary investment rounds. I mean, what are you going to do with all of this money? And at what point do you become a company which doesn't need any more investment but has to go public?
Well, the investments are, first of all, because it's a long journey. And we need to keep investing, yeah, to make our service provider happy. And we need to make them comfortable. There is enough in our tanks to allow us to run for the long run. Obviously, the goal will be to grow a big company and to go public. But this is a long journey. We are both after several startups, successful startup. So this one, we knew that it will take longer, and you need enough resources,
right,
to keep investing, because it's easy as a slogan to say we will move them into the new area of the cloud, but in reality it takes long years and effort and technology to make it happen.
So it's a constant R&D effort, I suppose?
And operations and sales, yeah.
And providing the level of service which telco or service providers need, which includes obviously reliability and predictability and that level of
24/7 support and whatever it's coming with a package to sell 5-9 solution to service providers.
And that seems to be what you were saying as well, Hillel, is that you have that laser focus on the service providers, which perhaps the company wouldn't be so successful if you had targeted multiple different verticals or industries to start with. Yeah.
You raise money as a tool to achieve something, to invest and create more value to our customer and to be able to cover more, I would call it the ecosystem for customer perspective. Okay, we are engaging with tens of customers as different steps, okay? Some of them are in POC lab, some of them in production, some of them we are in negotiation.
And it seems to be going fantastically well.
Thank you.
You have the, in some ways, you have the best type of competition, you know, the big incumbent vendors. They don't seem to be doing as much to compete in your space as they might be. Why do you think that is?
First, they're competing very hard. Mm-hmm. Second, for big company, it's very hard to change.
Right.
Very, very, very hard to change the culture, the product. You need the startup as disruptive to coming and, you know, shift it around.
Yeah.
I think this is the reason that we see, you know, AWS as a new vendor that came,
right,
and creates the biggest cloud in the world. Okay,
right.
Why not other vendors that was before? So we see competition from the incumbent. It's competing with the traditional,
yeah,
you know, product and the business model or the go-to-market. This is a reason that I think that we are able to win more and more. But this is the nature of any business that you disrupt.
In reality, it's you also can look at it differently and say, I mean, we don't mind about the competition. I mean, those are big companies and very successful, and in some aspects we admire them. But if they want to keep buying what they're buying in the last 20 years, I mean, there is nothing for us there.
Yeah.
We are in a different journey there. So we are not really looking, it's not a competition that you're looking what the competition is doing and try to improve. We are in a journey to take them into the network cloud area. And this is a totally different offer,
right,
with all the benefit associated with, and we are very focused on that. So in the outside, you can say, okay, they compete. In the reality, the service provider need to choose when is the right moment for them to move.
Yeah, I think the story of service providers has always been one of transitions. you know, it's a journey which has many transitions along the way. And, you know, these companies have been around for over 100 years in many cases, so they know about that. The thing which DriveNets has done is make a irresistible argument for the technology that you're selling. And it's just at just the right time for these companies. And as I was saying before, when we were first chatting, it's like there is no other company which is more representative of what Silverlinings is about than DriveNets. So we're really enjoying talking to you about this. And well, I'm going to be coming out to Israel to see you in person. You can give me the tour.
Looking forward.
You're welcome.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys.